asexual reproduction in animals. So what is the meaning of the, today we will discuss about the asexual reproduction of the animals, how should be the, they produce the different methods you can be observed in this class. So you already know about that the, in the sexual reproduction what happens means it is the fusion of the male and female gametes. After that one will come to the zygote, you can call it the fertilization. So either some animals they have the external fertilization, some animals should be given to the internal fertilization. Almost all mammals you can regard as the internal fertilization, like the reptiles, things. So all you can regard as the external fertilization should be, external fertilization should be take place, is it? So another one type you can regard as the asexual reproduction. So what is the meaning of asexual reproduction? So the words should be suggested that asexual means without any fusion of the male and female gametes, then we can define as the asexual reproduction. So we can see the asexual reproduction in the only in the lower form of the animals, so not only we can see in the higher form of the organisms. So maybe some of the organisms like an amoeba, hydra, or some of the you can aquatic animals like that we can observe the in this material. So first of all, what is the meaning of the asexual? So asexual reproduction means it is also one of the type of the reproduction, but only which can be involves the single parent. Either it should be the male or it should be the female. So then you can define as the asexual reproduction. Here do not involve the any male and female gametes, like sperm and egg cannot be observed. So only single parent they can be the due to the reproduction. So what are the examples? First of all, we can give the hydra. So if you observe the yeast, so like that also, that this type of reproduction is also taking place to the budding process. So like the yeast also, in this reproduction is also taking place to the budding. So in hydra, it should be process the different bulges on itself on the bulges. So it should be like this. So there is a, some tentacles we can be observed to here. So there is a, some tentacles type of the organisms. So there is a process of the some birds. So can be observed here. So the hydra process a different bulges on itself. That is to be called as the some of the bud formation. These buds should be developed in the individual hydra. Each hydra can be produced a different number of buds. So suppose this is the one bud means, so again they can be formation of the another bud should be formed like this. So like that you can be seen in the, it should be different bulges on itself, is called buds. This bud should be developed into the individual. Suppose this should be the breaker bud, then this is the formation of the new hydra should be formed. Each hydra can be produced a different number of. So in hydra, how should be the reproduction should be occur means, because they produce the numerous number of the birds should be produced. Yes, we can be seen in the this type of the hydra should be seen in the asexual reproduction. So second and third repeated that one. So like that in yeast also reproduction should be also take place through the process of the budding process. So budding means there be bulges itself. So they can be change their shape. So that is what we call as the birds. These birds should be developed in the individual, each hydra can be possessing different number of the birds. So next, if you case of the binary fusion method. So binary means what? Binary means two, that is what we call as the binary fusions. So fusion means the single nucleus should be divided into two equal parts, that is what we call as the binary fusions. So here the example we can be given to the single parent cell, that is you can be the amoeba, you can take the. So amoeba should be one of the shapeless cell. So here the single nucleus should be a formation. So after that they can be divided into two equal nucleus of the amoeba. So first process in amoeba they can be divided itself into the two individuals. So one single cell of the amoeba should be divided into two individuals. Their reproduction should be take place by, that is, it can be called as the binary fusion. So one should be divided into two 8 to 16 like that, it will be divided continuously. That process it will be called as the binary fission. So normally we know that it is the single cell of the nucleus. So that nucleus should be the divided into different form of the nucleus. So suppose this is a single nucleus, means they will be converted into divided into two different nuclei. So the plural forms we can be called as the nuclei. So then division of the body of the amoeba should be taking place at each part within the one nucleus. So after the division of the body, so each part, so this single nucleus should be divided into one, that divided into the single nucleus should be formed the two nuclei. So there is in the one nucleus, two amoeba produce a single egg. So as it should be the body of the amoeba should be taking place at each part should be received the one nucleus, so two amoeba produce a single parent. So it means whatever single parent, so this is the reason as the single parent, in this single parent they can be produce the two different type of the organism or different type of the amoeba we can be observed. So binary fission means it means divided into two or four, 16 like that. So single nucleus should be converted into double, that is what we call as the binary fissions. So normally we can be seen observed in the world into the binary fissions and budding process. So some other types of the organism also reproduce the another type, that is we can be called as the fragmentation. So fragmentation is also one of the another type of the sexual reproduction. So here the parent organism divides itself into different fragments. So fragments means we can be cut into body should be a three or four parts. So like this. So for example, if you observe the planaria, so it can be cut into three parts also. They can be again they can be regrowth, that is it can be called as the regeneration. Here the parental organism divides itself into different fragments where each fragment regenerate and also develop a new organism. If you cut into the anterior part or if you cut into the posterior part, again they can be developed into the new organisms. So what are the examples we can be given that one? So for example, shark or you can develop into the planaria and starfish. So these are some examples of the fragmentation process. So although, so you know that starfish is also, they can be one of the echinodermata, but it should be also capable of the asexual reproduction as well as, but many times they can be reproduced with the asexual process with the fragmentation. Because when the conditions is not favored for the sexual reproduction, then they can be started with the asexual reproduction. So almost all organisms should be the, they can be reproduced by the asexual by when the conditions are unfavorable. So this is the fragmentation. Fragmentation means the parental organism which can be divided itself into different fragments, each fragment should be regenerate and redevelop the organism, new organism, that is it will be called as the regeneration. Example we can give to the planaria and starfishes. So next one is parthenogenesis. So it can be called as the sometimes it can be called as the parthenopathy. So what is the meaning of the parthenopathy? In case of the plants or fruits, it can be taken into that one. So parthenopathy means it is nothing but a female organisms are capable of the producing egg without fertilization. So in case of plants also, and also sometimes it is seen observed in the animals also, they will be the females which can be capable of the producing the egg. But without fertilization, the egg should be developed into a new organism. That is, it can be called as a parthenogenesis. So, like if you observe in the, some of the aquatic animals like fishes, like a shark, maybe some birds or reptiles like lizards. So, in case of the lizards, also we can see in the list of the parthenogenesis. And also some few insects also they can be involved in the list parthenogenesis. Means without contact of the any male gametes, so they will be the female should be able to produce the capable of producing it without fertilization, that is it can be called as a parthenogenesis. So, but cannot be seen in the mammals. So dear student, so here we can discuss about the asexual reproduction. So you know that asexual reproduction means it is then nothing but they do not involve in the both male and female characters, gametes. That is, there is single parent will be responsible for that one. So maybe hydra and also you see in the some fragmentation process can be observed to that one. So in hydra it can be just like a yeast, the reproduction should be take place to the only process of the body. So the different bulges on itself it can be cut as the birds. These birds should be developed into new individual. This is you can be cut as the formation of the different number of the birds. So like that, if you observe the some lower form of the animals like a planaria or starfish, it can be seen in the fragmentation. It means the organism divide itself into different number of the fragments. It means it can be cut into any parts. It can be again it can be reformed. It can be cut as the fragmentation. So lastly, bifurcation means the organism which can be developed into a new individual. Okay, divided into two. One single nucleus should be divided into two nuclei. That is, we can call as the primary fissures. So parthenogenesis means the female which can be the capable of the producing egg. So without fertilization, so that is we can call as the parthenogenesis. So these are the different types of the asexual reproduction. So the students, now we can be discussing the in this lesson sexual mode of reproduction and also asexual mode of reproduction. So in you know, can be observed in the in vivo or in vitro fertilization. So in vivo or in vitro fertilization means, so whatever the uterus which can be developed into our body, so the sperm should be taken from the another organism, then they can be inserted into the surrogate mother. They can be developed. That is, it can be called as the IVF or it can be called as the in vitro fertilization. Those are the do not bearing of the child, then it can be seen in the this type of the technique. It can be observed to that one. So like that, we can be seen in the one of the best example we can give to the sheep. So dolly fish also we can be able to use the like that. So whatever